Thank you so much for joining us. We're the Notre Dame Symphony Orchestra. This is our second fall concert, in fact. We begin with the rousing John Adams. The brass can now get some oxygen here with a a string piece that follows. Astor Piazzolla, the tango master of Argentina, wrote four seasons of Buenos Aires, not really as a suite, but successively over several years. And after his death, Guidon Kramer, the violinist, commissioned orchestral arrangements of all four and then paired them with Vivaldi's Four Seasons. And the arrangements actually tweaked the pieces a little bit and made them more like fast, slow, fast kind of structures to mirror the structure of the Four Seasons of Vivaldi, the four concerti, fast, slow, fast form concerti. And Kramer paired them so to contrast with the Boreal Seasons and the Astral Seasons, so that the spring of the Four Seasons by Vivaldi matched fall of the Four Seasons of Piazzolla, and he incorporated some thematic resemblances and things. It's a really interesting set. It's all available on YouTube, his recording with his wonderful, I think he calls it, he kind of cheekily, his Kremerata, is this group that he formed in northern Germany, his wonderful chamber orchestra. Our soloist on that is Abbey. Should I tell him that you only learned it, picked it up last week? Oh, I just did. Okay, so we're thrilled that Abbey Fontana joins us as a soloist on this. After that, we'll do Sorcerer's Apprentice. And Sorcerer's Apprentice is, it's been so exciting to work on it. I think it's unfairly maligned as this piece of light concert music. First of all, it's virtuosic in every part, including this killer Glockenspiel part. From the Glockenspiel to the first violin, it's a you know, very, very significant virtuosic challenge for the players. But also, it's a really, really important work in terms of its harmonic ingenuity. It's based on the augmented chord rather than the major or minor chord. The piece is kind of putatively an F minor, but it's based on this augmented chord that has a lot of tonal uncertainty to it. That kind of indicates, I think it's a forward-looking step away from orientation with in major and minor keys, even though, again, it's kind of, you know, formally in F minor, but it's just this brilliant orchestral showpiece, of course, in its orchestration, famously included in Fantasia, where the Sorcerer's Apprentice is played by Mickey Mouse, and we returned to that here in recent weeks, too. I encourage you to go back to it, because it's probably the most, of all the pieces in Fantasia, it's probably the most closely resemblant of both the thematic, story of all the pieces, as well as the music itself. For example, the Rite of Spring in Fantasia was all cut to pieces and rearranged, but Sorcerer's Apprentice is pretty much all the way intact. And then after the break, we'll continue with Brahms' wonderful second symphony in D major, beautiful sonorous piece, makes us imagine spring even though winter approaches. I guess we'll have to go to Buenos Aires for our spring. So, thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope you enjoy our concert program.
Thank you. Thank you.